Oh god damn it, My Hero Academia Season 4 is over. Well, I can always rewatch Inazuma 11 Ares. Hey everybody, it's me, Ear from Bull MHA, and welcome to part 2 of my Inazuma 11 Ares review series. I had to re-upload part 1 two times, uploaded it for the first time just there now, so hopefully this one will go off without a hitch. We can only hope. Let's jump into episode 3 and then 4. Anyway, it's a new day and Asta wakes up at 6 a.m. and has his hair perfect. And he's wide awake. Asta defies so many laws of just being a kid. It's slightly irritating. Anyway, training begins and your boy Goji just isn't taking it really seriously, and that pisses off Osamaru. We'll get into why that is really pissing him off later. The manager shows up on scene talking about how some of the players are gonna learn some hisatsus. Ooh, very interesting. They're then in the club room and they're being shown the team they will be facing off. This is the team. And they're known for their iron wall-like defense. So they're going to need something to break through that wall. After being told that they wouldn't practice attacking for the next couple training drills, Kazamura is just really not with it. He really just dislikes the manager and doesn't think he knows what he's doing. But the training seems to be going well. So, question is, what is the manager thinking? So the manager decides who will be learning each hisatsu by picking names out of a hat. Well, not a hat, a box, but still. The guy's a nar. At least that's what you think. Anyway, the two names are picked out. Harura and Iwata have to wake up at the correct, not even at bloody light, just to get training started, which involves cleaning the skull. Fun. Anyway, the two do it all morning and they make the skull look really nice, but the question is, how is this gonna help perform a hisatsu? Guess we'll have to find out. Harura apparently learned a new trick to make washing the windows a whole lot easier, but again, how's this gonna help? Also, he soaked his teammates. What a dick. And Iwata learned a new trick how to wash walls. It's called using both his damn hands. Simple enough, right? And this little guy is messing up the walls. He's the manager's minion. You don't know that yet. Kazamura didn't come to dinner, so Asta went looking for him. Sees him out in the balcony, just sitting there looking at the stars, and they decide to have a chat. Kazamura then tells Asta the story of how he met Goenji Shuya, the flame striker. After trying to help a woman after a man stole her bag, he couldn't catch him. But one swift kick of a football and he was done for. Kazamura was then inspired to follow in his footsteps and learn the fire tornado. Noraka then finds the two and asks and tells them to come back so they can all eat together because it's better and all that shit. And yeah. Kazamura then realizes that that is true. It's better to have friends than no one. They then get kitted up in their brand new sponsored kits and yeah, it completes the look in my opinion. Then Takeshi comes around with an update on the situation, and what a surprise, Anna's now a manager too. Then we get introduced to the player licenses, the next part of the merchandise. Alongside the 11 band, now we have these things. Basically, they act like a little like key card and all that, but you can buy them, and I'll be honest, I want them. Good lord, prices are insane because you gotta get it imported from Japan. Oh yeah, and there's trading cards as well, but I don't think anyone really cares about those. We then get a confrontation between Hisaki and Nosaka. I just realized I haven't talked about Nosaka yet. And I don't plan to. Match time, baby! I am so hyped for this match! Oh hey look, an original Rival member! Can't wait to see him in action! Oh, he's injured. God damn it! Well, at least we'll get to see this match. Wait, that's it? Oh, god damn it, I was waiting forward to that match! Episode 4 just starts with Rymon passing it around because, well, they can't really attack to get through the wall, so what's the point? They then set a trap for Austo, setting him straight into the line of a defender.
Ranking, stay!
Then Goji falls for the same plan and similar results happen. We cut to the second half because nothing really happens. The way manager gets reckless, starts on the team to go on the attack. As the wall move forward, they're about to shoot, but it turns out, Rymon have a wall of their own. And with one swift fire tornado later, it's 1-0 to Rymon. In Japanese, tornado sounds like lemonade, so Goji says fire lemonade, and it always misses. Yet now the wall moves, but Harura sees that there's a gap, and decides to use pinpoint accuracy to get through. The pass is perfect, landing straight at Austo's feet, for him to shoot. And of course, it's a goal. 2-0, and that realistically wraps up the episode. And that's it for part 2. Thank you guys for watching again. And part 1, minimum out of copyrights was 2. But it's not much. It's not monetized. But since my channel's so small, I can't really monetize videos yet anyway. So thank you guys for watching. Next part will probably come out maybe not tomorrow, possibly tomorrow though. Depending on what I feel like. But for the rest of today, I'm going to take it to myself. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Peace out.